Holy shit. This episode was so goddamn amazing. And I'm still mad that it's ending. Now, I still feel like how I feel about when I said about the Tournament of Power, that most of it was definitely a waste of time to see how they're rushing this whole Jiren and Goku arc, the whole Ultra Instinct thing. It just feel rushed. But these last couple episodes have been amazing. Just to sit here and watch this shit, knowing how Jiren was so powerful throughout this whole, you know, tournament and just demolishing people left and right, and to see what's happening now, oh man, it was definitely worth the wait. But sadly, next week is the last episode, and I'm really sad about that, because this seemed like it could have been an interesting series if they would have really kind of cut certain things out and added certain things. But this episode has so many different surprises that it blew me away, you know, because I watch a lot of Dragon Ball Z channels, and from what was being told, we basically knew, like, if you watch like Geekdom 101 or Mastar Media and I think Dooley, and it's one more channel that I can't think of right now, but I watch a lot of those people, and I watch them, you know, spoilers and shit, I don't really care, I just still want to see the episode. So the way that the notes that came out for this particular episode, it wasn't even like that. I had no clue what was about to happen at the end of the episode, so I walked away from this shocked as hell, like, oh my god. I definitely thought it was over for Goku though. Like, the only thing that I will say I didn't appreciate is, like, you build all this up for him to get Ultra Instinct, and the minute he gets it, like, this is the third time getting it. He got it, lost it, got it, lost it. Then he so-called mastered it. If he mastered it, I didn't agree with how all of a sudden he reached his limits and, you know what I mean, his body breaks down. At the fucking end, when he's about to eliminate Jiren, but this is the thing with Goku that I never liked about him. When it's time to put the enemy away, you bullshit. This is the same thing with his son was facing Perfect Cell, you know what I mean? Goku and then was mad because he wouldn't finish this nigga. He was playing with him. The power got to his ego and he just felt overconfident or whatever. And then you see what happened. Goku had to basically sacrifice his life, but then Gohan eventually did kill Cell. So it's like you got Jiren on the ropes, and instead of just, you could have just ninja kicked the nigga like straight off the stage and y'all won. He bullshit, body breakdown, and Jiren does his little power ball, like pew, and it's like, damn, goodbye Goku, it's over with. But no, just wait, a fucking ball of energy just comes and hits that nigga in his chest and knocks him on another piece of ground or whatever, you know what I mean, the tournament ring, a piece of the ring, whatever. And I'm like, what the fuck? And I know Frieza was still alive and there, but I didn't think he, you know, had any energy left. And so we see him and it's like, oh shit, he in his golden form. And then we look and it's Android 17. And it's like, what the fuck? I literally thought he blew himself up. And that's crazy that it's three people still left for Universe 7. And it's like, what, 30 seconds left in the tournament? So if Jiren don't really knock these motherfuckers off, he loses, his universe loses and it gets erased. But I loved everything about the episode, the fighting, the animation of it, the graphics, just how certain moves were made to make Goku just seem like such a savage. And I like the dialogue they gave between both of them, how the reason what Goku does is not for himself, it's for his friends, it's protect them, like, you know, he's basically the savior. And Jiren just looks at all that like, forget friends and I don't care about that, it's all about power, if I have power I have nothing. And at one point they show this nigga throw a ball of energy towards, you know, where Krillin and him is at, basically Universe 7, and Goku, he went stupid. Y'all know how he feel when people try to hurt his friends, so he definitely beat the shit out of him. And then that's when he loses, like, I guess, Ultra Instinct. His body just overcame with, you know, just basically broke down. And I was like, what the fuck? Like, wow. And then, as you see of the preview for the next episode, it's going to be Goku, Frieza, Android 17, basically attacking Jiren or whatever the case may be. Obviously, somebody wins because you can see the dragon at the end of the episode, somebody making a wish or whatever the case may be. And I want to know what happens, because it's like, you look at Beerus in the Supreme Kai's face, they just look shocked. It's not really a shock to where they're scared or worried. It's just like a, I don't believe it, what the hell type of look on their face. But yeah, this episode was pretty damn awesome, man. And I was scrolling through YouTube trying to find this shit. And I hate when people upload bullshit to their channel and just dub it, you know what I mean, or name it episode so-and-so and it ain't that, just for views. You motherfuckers gotta stop doing that. Or they'll upload somebody else content that ain't even that episode, or some bullshit ass animation. And not everybody can do animation, you know what I mean? So y'all need to cut that shit out. So it took me a cool little minute to find it. I ended up watching it in the language, the Japanese language or whatever, and then I look for an English dub version, basically with subtitles and shit, so until I can find the English dub version. But that shit was definitely dope, man. Like, goddamn. And I'm still looking for the movie. I'm looking forward to it to see, like, you know, what that gonna be about. It's gonna be about Saiyans and everything, because we're a couple months away. Like, a lot of people is excited about Infinity War. Yeah, cool. I'm really definitely more excited for the Dragon Ball Z movie. I definitely want to see what that's about, you know. But this episode is awesome, man. I definitely can't wait to the last one. And it's supposed to be like some type of special thing after the episode, so I definitely want to see what all that's about. I feel like that episode should be at least an hour long instead of just, like, you know, the minimal. But if y'all into Dragon Ball Super, y'all saw the episode, definitely let me know what you thought about it, man. And how do y'all feel about Goku Ultra Instinct form? Do you feel like it's a waste? And if they do bring back Dragon Ball Super in 2019, because I think that's what they're going to do, you think that he'll keep the form, or at the end of this arc where he go with the Grand Priest and train more, or I don't know, like, what will he do? Y'all let me know what y'all thought about it. I'm Holler. One.